Hello, it's me, Bishop Rebecca. I'm a PACM CEO, and this is our little mascot dog, Josie. Josie, look in the camera. Say hello. You're the mascot. That's a girl. She's looking for snacks. That's why she's up here, because she always tried to blackmail her with some snacks, but not happening. What I'd like to do is just introduce myself, Phoenix Alive Christian Ministries, PACM, Bishop Rebecca, and I would like to read a little something, because I'm just new at this. So, I would like to read 1 Corinthians 13. It's a love chapter, and it's our wedding vows. My favorite chapter. It's God's love. It's not the love of human beings apart from Christ. It's the love of God being sacrificial love. And so it is to be, it says here, preferred to the gifts, although the gifts are certainly very important in ministry, and five full callings, and the Bible acknowledges this, but it says as important as those are, it's even more preferred to develop in our love, the love of God and towards one another. And this was a command of Jesus, Him, God, towards Him and one another. So, without any further ado, here it is, 1 Corinthians 13, our wedding vows. And now I will show you the most excellent way. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but I have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains, but have not love, I'm nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails, but where there are prophecies, they will cease, and where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part, but when perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became a man or woman, I put childish ways behind me. Now we see but a poor reflection as in a mirror, or see through a glass darkly. Then we shall see face to face, when we come face to face with the Lord. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Now that's my favorite verse, the whole Bible, mine and my sister Samara as well. Bishop Samara. And it's one we try to pattern our life after. It's not easy, and it would be absolutely impossible to do this or accomplish this, to become perfected in this kind of love, in this love, the love of God, without the presence of the Holy Spirit and without being saved by God. It would not be possible, because we're not saved by works. We're saved by the enabling power of the Holy Spirit in the second birth, when He comes to live in us immediately upon salvation. And so then, we are saved, we are babes, and we progressively mature, and the maturity that the Holy Spirit 24/7 leads us into is this 1 Corinthians 13, against which there is no law. And so this is why we're not under the law, because we actually become trees of life, ministering trees of life, more and more so. If in fact we belong to the Lord, we will have the Holy Spirit in us, leading and guiding us in all truth, and developing in the power of love rather than what the world has, the world that we've left upon salvation, which is a world that patterns itself on the love of power. But we become ministers of righteousness with the power of love, which heals, redeems, feeds, leads, guides, champions, and finally overcomes all things. In the name of Jesus Christ, we're glorified and perfected in Him. And we bring glory to the Father through the Son, who's come to live and guide and teach us in all ways. And so 1 Corinthians 13 is all about this love walk that we enter into when we're saved. For us, this resurrection life that comes into us and makes it possible for us to become true sons and daughters of God, manifestation.